Alright, good morning again, YouTube and Saints. It's a prep day and I'm working today, as I do most prep days. But I thought you might get some benefits out of seeing what I was doing today. And so I'd like to show you first, if you remember the duck and goose area from other videos, it was getting really nasty and wet and mucky in the bottom, and we had put some hay down, but the hay just sort of ends up clumping up and it becomes compost. It's a good way to compost the hay, but it's not gonna make a very nice surface to walk on. And we're gonna have really cold weather in the next couple days, so all this wet ground and rain that we've been having is gonna freeze. So I started putting down a layer of mulch, and as you can see, it's not even really a pile anymore. There used to be a pile of mulch here earlier when we had tomato plants, but it's kind of been beaten down, but there's still about a good 3 inches there. So one of the things I thought you might be benefited from, and you'll have to forgive me because I'm all by myself, is I thought you might like to know a little bit about shoveling, especially for you ladies out there. This is a full-size shovel, and if you've never shoveled, you should give it a try sometime. There's a whole technique to it. And so first thing is, use some force when you get it in the ground. Push it in and then push the end of it, and you'll see how easy it is to dig in. Then bend your knees, pick up whatever you're shoveling and pour it wherever it needs to go. That's one technique, and you can do it more than one time. As you see, you can get bigger or smaller shovel loads according to what you can move. And then the other part of it is, once you've gotten it in the ground, if it's something tough or you're not able to get very deep with it, you put a foot on here, and you do want to wear boots or some sort of heavy-soled shoes, because tennis shoes and things, you'll feel that metal of that shovel right through the bottom of your shoe. So you put your foot on the blade and you put your weight on it. You lean on it and you see an immediate result there, and then you shovel that up. And so one more time, push it in the ground. If you need a little extra help, put your foot on it. You can use either foot, push down. Oh, that one's not working too well. We hit rock. And then bend your knees, pick up your load, dump. And now, just to finish the video, I'll show you that this is only half full, but when I filled these up and I tried to carry them, they were really heavy, and I'm careful in my back. So what I've decided to do is not fill them quite as much because the mulch is wet. I can do it a whole bucket if the mulch is dry, but the mulch has been rained on for 2 days, so it's wet. Well, you see the part of the ground here, yucky, muddy duck muck, and put the mulch down and then spread it a little bit and cover it, and it should make a nice spongy absorbent. The way they describe it in the Back to Eden Garden is an absorbent, and it allows things to leak out. And so this should be a really good base for these ducks and should last for a little while. All right. Have a good prep day, YouTube and Saints, and I will see you all later.